Track of the fin section. We've got our numbers written here. We can hear with our micrometer. We get on either side of the fin. We see what we've got for a reading. We check it on both sides of the strip here, so we make sure we got a nice, even dimension on both sides. Adjust your stand accordingly to get your dimensions to match the setup chart. Don't forget to go back after your adjustment and use your straight edge to make sure that your path stayed nice and parallel after adjustment. Jog that dimension on through, check your side roll path. Set it according to the setup chart. Again, jog it on through. Again, check your next pin pass on both sides. Compare to the setup chart. Make your adjustments accordingly. Jog it on through. Again, check your side pass stand right before the last pin. Set it up to the setup chart. Jog it on through. Make your last check on your fin pass. Again, compare it to the setup chart on both sides. Just like we did earlier, make sure you check for parallel out of each and every driven stand. And don't forget your side pass stand. When you make your adjustments, make sure that you've chased the top tie bar accordingly so you don't have the rolls that are flared out. Make sure you've got your 4 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, just like you do on the driven passes. 1, 2, 3, 4, you've got 4 points of contact with your straight edge to ensure that your rolls are parallel. Another figure that we can double check is the fin passes. Prepare the edges for welding and reduce the outside periphery of the material growth that we had in the breakdown. And here on your setup chart, you'll see where we have an OSP or a girth measurement. We can double check ourselves also besides taking a reading with the mic by going with our pie tape and lining up the line with the edge right here and lining up the numbers there and see just exactly what we have and again compare it to the setup chart.